Our package should have come yesterday. Did you check with Swifter?
Yes, Professor. I sent them a message this morning like you said. I know it's delicate.
And dangerous. I know. Sorry, I'm just getting paranoid. What was that?
I don't know. I think I know where our package is.
Swifter Post. We deliver.
Hey everybody, good to see you all. Today, let's take a look at how you turn your Android phone into a virtual production camera for your project in Unreal Engine 5. There's a lot of videos about using an iPhone, but not many of them for the Android users, so let's fill that gap. Before we get started, let me give you a quick heads up. Not all the Android phones, especially the older models, are currently supported by Google AR Core. To check if your phone is supported, go to developers.google.com/AR/devices, I left a link below, and look for make and model of your phone. With this out of the way, let's jump right in. First, we need to install the virtual plugin for Unreal Engine, which can be purchased from the Epic Marketplace. Once you've bought it, simply hit Install to Engine, select the engine version you want it to be installed to, and hit Install. And while it's working, let's download the virtual app from the Google Play Store and install it on your phone. Next, we need to set up a few things in Unreal Engine before we can start shooting. Go to Settings, Plugins, search for Virtual Plugin there, and enable it. Also make sure that the take recorder is enabled. And now we can restart the editor, you know the drill. Okay, the editor is back, now head over to Project Settings and find Always Show Touch Interface. The plugin will use it for the on-screen controls on your phone. Finally, we need to switch the simulation method to play in new editor window. Remember this step because the plugin won't work otherwise. Now let's set up the camera. Go to your content browser and search for the plugin's blueprint. If you don't see the plugin folders there, go to the display settings and turn on engine content and plugin content. And now you should see it. Scroll down to find the virtual plugin content, grab My Actor blueprint and drop it into the level. Next, let's add the camera to the level and connect it with the plugin. With My Actor selected, go to the Details panel. Under the Body section, find the Main Camera drop-down and add your camera there. It's also good to add it below to the Multi-Cine Array. Alright, we're all set. First, make sure that your phone is connected to the same Wi-Fi network as your PC. Turn on the virtual app on your phone and hit the play button in the editor. The first thing you'll need is your computer's IP. It shows for just a split second on the top left corner of your viewport, so what I usually do at first launch is taking a screen grab to write it down. Now all we need to do is type this IP in the app, press connect button, and here we go. Sometimes it takes a while and a few tries to make the app pick up. And I'm not sure if it's just my phone or it's a common issue, so please let me know in the comments if you're facing the same thing. Now let's take a look at the app. The H icon shows and hides the interface. The cog displays the window where you can adjust the stabilization, lock the camera movement, set camera properties, turn tracking on and off, or switch between the cameras in your scene if you added more than one. The small arrow on the left lets you switch between automatic and manual focus, and the drop-down on the right controls the focal length. Then you have joysticks. The left one moves the camera forward, backward, left and right, and the right one moves it up and down. You probably won't use them much, except maybe for setting the camera into a start position. And finally, the record button, which will bring up the take recorder and record your camera. Alright, now we can give it a try. Okay, the camera is following the phone and it all gets recorded. And nice. Now you can head over to the take browser up here and play your sequence. Well, let's say we've animated a scene already and all we need is a camera movement. Let's take the elevator scene that you saw at the beginning. The sequence doesn't have any camera yet, but that's where the plugin comes in. I need a scene to play while I'm recording.
Our package should have come yesterday.
There are three methods you can approach this, but only one worked for me. Method 1, with my actor selected, attach your sequence to the blueprint here. Method 2, you need your take recorder open. If it's not, go to the window menu, cinematics, take recorder. Then open the drop-down menu at the top and you can add your sequence there. And method 3, and this is rather a workaround, but that's the only one that actually worked. The take recorder creates a generic 5 seconds long sequence named pending take. We will use that as our base. Simply drag and drop your sequence into that take and adjust take's length to match your sequence. And that's it. Alright, we all set. Let's shoot our scene. 3, 2, 1, action.
Our package should have come yesterday. Did you check with Swifter?
Yes, Professor.
I can move around freely and the camera follows my phone as expected. I can repeat this a few times, shooting at different angles, to use it later in edit. During the process, the take recorder will build a sequence for you. If you use the third method I showed you, your sequences will look like this. Inside, you will find a subscene with your recorded camera and a sequence you've added before to the generic pending take. Each camera recording is saved into its own subscenes folder in your content browser. And now we can edit our sequence. We can do it either in sequencer directly or render each camera and edit in any external package. I made a fresh sequence, added my animation at the bottom, and used just the camera subsequences in my edit, but you don't have to do it the same way. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope you found it useful, and if you have any questions or if you run into any issues along the way, feel free to leave a comment below and I'll do my best to help you out. Be sure to subscribe so you don't miss any future videos, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching!